Well, Everton are again without Andy Johnson because of his ankle problems. Youngsters Victor Anichebe and James Vaughan will lead the attack. Phil Neville drops back to right back with Tony Hibbert on the bench. Manuel Fernandez plays against his former club. Portsmouth have problems at the back. There's still no Sol Campbell, and Dejan Stefanovic is also out. Noe Pamaro comes in. Matt Taylor and Richard Hughes also miss out through injury. So in comes Sean Davis and Nico Cranshaw, who scored against Liverpool last week.
Number 6, Jimmy Traore. Number 10, Lauren. Number 11.
Well, 9 months of hard work and toil for these two clubs could be down to this. A winner takes all European shootout. Victory would not guarantee that, but it would make it almost certain for Everton and would put Portsmouth in the driving seat if they were to snatch the 3 points. Both managers describing this as a must-win and massive. The continent is calling, but who will make it?
Bravest, who's got more belief, are the ones who'll make it.
Well, David Moyes and Harry Redknapp on the verge of something special. Moyes, of course, has been there before, but for Harry Redknapp, this would be history if Portsmouth were to make it into Europe. There's Phil Neville. Primus with the header away from Vaughan. And Teta heading it back, and the first test here for the Portsmouth back four. Phil Neville claims it's a corner, but goal kick is the decision.
Well, you wouldn't wish for a better leader on an afternoon like this. Phil Neville, well, at the highest level all through his career. See, more highs than lows without a doubt. But they've got to get past that man. He's in terrific form.
Has had a fantastic season, David James. Unlike many players, wants to cap it. There's something at the end of it. The carrot of Europe is dangling for these two sets of players. It's all about bottle. It's all about delivering now. Everton with this free kick. Of course, you talk about the players that are here wanting the bonus of getting into Europe. It will also help the managers attract players to the club in the summer as well. The prospect of European football, that's Lee Carsley with the first shot in anger.
Everton have got to do is get consistency into their play at the moment. I saw them at West Ham a couple of weeks back, and they weren't at the best without a doubt. West Ham win the game 1-0. Then you see them play the way they did against Manchester United to go 2-0 up and all of a sudden capitulate. So David Moyes will sure have been trying to address that and get them in a positive frame of mind.
Yobo with the header, and each of these sweeping the ball towards Leon Osman. This is Johnson for Portsmouth. It's Julian Lescott with the clearance, almost turned into the perfect pass, but Linvoy Primus tidying up. Of weight on Primus's shoulders today with no Campbell, no Stefanovic.
He's got to lead by example. I think the loss of Campbell is going to be a big one, obviously. I think he's led by example since he signed on for Portsmouth. I think that's helped Primus this season. A great understanding, the two of them. Got to do without him.
Amazing to think that Harry Redknapp was thinking about getting rid of Primus 5 years ago. Didn't think he was good enough for the Championship. Yep, he's been outstanding for Portsmouth, especially this campaign. This is Stubbs trying to set Vaughan away. That will be a throw in Everton's way. Primus plotted by Noe Pamaro today. Everton will try and work on that.
You think with Andy Johnson in there they'll have a chance?
Neville's throw in towards Anichebe, just caught on the back of the head. Neville again scooping the ball forward.
And those sort of balls into the box will be no problem for Primus to deal with. Thrives on that sort of challenge. And he got beat there.
James Vaughan does win many, many flick-ons.
You don't expect him to either. You look at Primus against him and you think he'll be the dominant force, but it's a good early win from Vaughan. what you like to do as a centre forward, a striker. You like to win your first challenge against your marker, and he certainly did that, Vaughan. Make Primus think a little bit more.
Interesting to see Vaughan and Anichebe in attack today for Everton, the two big mates, the two players who've signed extended contracts here this week. This is Anichebe. Everton have started the brighter, but Portsmouth putting themselves around in terms of tackles.
Don't be surprised to see a scrappy first 10-15 minutes. Nerves are out there. They know the rewards. They managed to get in the top seven.
Anichebe claims he was caught there just on the edge of the penalty area.
Well, clearly fears he was caught there. There's not a great deal of contact for me in between the two defenders.
This is Jimmy Traore for Portsmouth. Benjani waiting inside the penalty area. There's Carney. Ball now with Sean Davis, faced by Fernandez. First chance here for Portsmouth to run at the Everton back line. Alan Stubbs will just shield that ball out of play.
Oh, Vaughan. Everton clearly thought they had a shout here. I don't think there's much in that at all. It's been very, very harsh to give a penalty for that.
Now it's Nico Cranshaw. Everton made the quicker start, but Portsmouth put themselves into this game now. O'Neill, Paul Pastor.
That much for the man on the ball to it. There's not many options out there. I mean, just standing is static and not moving defenders out of the way. They've got more awareness of what's around them.
Another throw in to Portsmouth. Mikel Arteta, when you have a player of his skill, he needs to be involved. He's wandering in field now just to try and pick up the ball because Everton are playing it long.
Play it long and down the two centre-half strokes, you have to get midfield pushing on to get the second ball, the bits and pieces that come around the 18-yard box.
Thoughts with the game, working well in a tight area. Joseph Yeoba has some defending to do here, which he just about does, as Gary O'Neill went bursting through.
That's a weird defending for you, because they held a very high line there, tried to play offside. Portsmouth spotted it, and the run of O'Neill caught them out, and Yeoba not been aware, they're in big trouble.
Another opportunity then here for Portsmouth, 0-0. Tight game so far, I should expect between these two. Primus with the header, he rose well.
That's going to be an absolute cracker from that distance to beat. Goalkeeper, more or less, on the 18-yard box this. How far he is away there, to get that on target from that distance is very, very difficult.
Again, the target, Anichebe, who's put it through to James Ward. Chance here! Big chance for Everton, and they've blown it.
Well, that's criminal. No matter what you do, you have to hit the target. I was always told that as a striker. The goalkeeper saves it fine. Direct this time, it works. And Anichebe gets a header. Look at this, acres of space. He steadies himself and you think he's going to nestle in the net. And he misses the target, totally. Primus just gets underneath it a little bit. And you think, just hit the target, totally off balance. He steadies himself well in the first place. There he steadies himself. And then just snatches at it, and that's poor.
Well, for once, the long ball over the top did work. James Vaughan couldn't pounce on it. The Evertonians are lifted by that. This is Osman. Lescott out to his left. Well, you can hear the frustration rolling down from the stands here at Goodison Park.
Well, you don't want the fans doing that, especially so early in the game, getting on the backs of the players. Players know how important this game is. They are trying to do the best. Nobody means to put a pass astray.
This is Cranshaw for Portsmouth. Everton then with the best chance of the game so far, squandered though by a young James Ball. Tussle between Yobo and Benjani. Stubbs clearing for Everton. This is Fernandez. Arteta just stepping in field again to try and pick up possession and try to create. And the target is James Bourne, he's onside. Osman and Ichibi and Arteta in the middle. So two primers.
Game too easy. Too easy just to put it in the box sometimes. Take responsibility.
And Julian Lescott will try and throw this ball long, looking for Vaughan. Again, it's Primus in the way, and Cranshaw nudging the ball away from Arteta. There's Phil Neville. High ball towards Leon Osman. Good head down looking for an Ichibi.
Well, if you're going to put a ball in the box, that's how you do it. You angle it to the far post. Give players a chance to attack it. Lovely ball by Phil Neville. He stays onside, Osman. Intelligent header across. Nothing wrong with that. Just could not get the final touch. So unselfish. Could have gone for goal. Didn't. Just needed that touch there. That's decent defending in the end. Just a put. Need to be off.
He wants at least six players during the summer to keep Portsmouth challenging in the top ten next season. He's had to keep a lid on expectations since around Christmas time, when Portsmouth fans were in full voice singing we're on a European tour.
He should be given the funds to do that as well. The job he's done here at Portsmouth.
There's James Vaughan. It was a good take that by Vaughan. Looks to bring him down on the edge of the penalty area. He did.
And that's where he's so good, Vaughan. Gets it in there on the edge of the box, twists and turns. Sort of difficult to defend against. He's on the move straight away. Gambles a little bit. That's where he's so good. And you just touch him, he's going to go down there.
David James knows he has a big test here. Mikel Arteta. Alan Stubbs are standing over the ball. Of course, Stubbs scored last week here at the other end against Manchester United.
There'll be two totally different styles of free kick. I think one will be an absolute blockbuster, the other will be a bit more cultured.
There's plenty of blue shirts in the middle of that Portsmouth wall as well, and just on the edge of it. Alan Stubbs is telling Lee Carsley to move into the wall a little bit more.
Wall doesn't look 10 yards away, does it? What wall does?
Looks fragmented too. Well, Stubbs has moved away. It's Mikel Arteta. It's in the edge of that wall. Phil Neville sold short, and the break is on here for Portsmouth. If they can work this right, Jimmy Traore has Davis and O'Neill bursting through the middle. O'Neill's in space. He couldn't find him, and then he was brought down by Arteta.
Well, Gary O'Neill absolutely furious, and rightly so. There was a yellow card there, and that's the right decision, but it should have been better than this. It was a terrific break. You look at O'Neill's run, he's in acres of space, and he checks back. Look at his arms up in the air, and he's absolutely livid. The delivery should have come before that, and it's a good chance gone begging.
From one end to the other. Better ball was needed by Traore. But they do have this free kick, which Nico Cranshaw is standing over. Hits it towards that far post. It's a dangerous delivery.
Terrific delivery. A striker, a centre-half coming up, when he delivers, Cranshaw is delivered there. You just know you've got a half a chance of getting half a yard on your marker and getting in a good challenge.
Still a cagey game between these two. You can feel the nerves around Goodison Park, jingle jangling. Carney robbed of the ball. Again, their first thought is to hit it long.
don't look like they're going to get through. They've had that one chance where Vaughan got clear and missed the target, but apart from that domination from the centre-half to Portsmouth. You look at this situation here, neither keeper's had a save to make yet.
O'Neill, and then the shot from Nico Cranshaw, and Howard has a save.
Until then, yes. He'll save those all day. At least it's a shot on target.
Vaughan rising again, this time it's Panero who's behind him. Race on between Johnson and Osman. Throwing Portsmouth's way. Portsmouth end the season at home to Arsenal next week, while Everton go to Chelsea. Both teams need a win. You'd expect at least one win, at least 3 points if they're to realise their dream of finishing in the European place. Everton have applied for the Intertoto Cup, Portsmouth haven't. Need to be a flick on once more. Portsmouth have a man down. It's Noe Pamara. After jumping there with James Vaughan.
Again, it's a long direct ball. There's a nudge there, that was a foul. But again, Primus in prime position to deal with it. Definitely a fend off there. You've got to be stronger than that, though. Stay on your feet.
Camaro will be back on shortly. Interesting to see there, Lee Carsley talking to Anichebe and James Vaughan. Well, there was a stoppage in play there. Maybe just selling a little bit of experience to the two strikers.
Saying the only option you're giving us is that long ball. One of you's got to come towards the ball, the other go long and then switch around. But at the moment he's probably saying you're both too flat, it's difficult to hit you.
I know David Moyes is calling for a big atmosphere here today, but it's a fairly quiet Goodison Park. There are those nervy fans. Lescott rising with Benjani. Cranshaw after this gets there just ahead of Mikel Arteta. Yeva with the header. Vaughan can really get a foot on the ball. This is Vaughan scrapping. Osman and Ichebe trying to stay onside. Now he's trying to run around Primus.
It's a little bit better. Trying to thread the way through instead of going long.
O'Neill for Portsmouth, Carnew in the middle, so to Cranshaw, still O'Neill, moves the ball back a long way towards Davis, but given away by him. I think both managers will probably want to get the teams in a hard time, and Harry Redknapp I suppose would take a point here, but David Moyes knows his team must win here. We'll tell them to do a bit more of this, playing the ball wide and getting the likes of Arteta involved. Arteta taking on Johnson, tries to win the corner and does do.
It's better, you've got a player there who wants to take the defender on. Just to commit defenders, he did that and he's got a corner.
Everton asking the questions here. And this corner kick, final 5 minutes of the first half. Arteta with that corner, too close to David James. This is Neville. Carsley has plenty to aim for and swings it towards Julian Lescott. Arteta's behind him, but the whistle's blown. There was an offside and also a little nudge, I think, spotted by Howard Webb.
It's nice to see him get forward. He's trying to make something happen. It's very, very tight, that is. He's in line though, the assistant. That's not offside, he must have given it for a foul.
I think Howard Webb was indicating a foul, but Glenn Turner's flag did go up there also for offside.
certainly wasn't.
Primus.
You can hear the fans feel the same as we do. Again, that long ball straight under Primus's head.
Les got closed down by Ben John. Isn't the case sometimes, Gary, when your manager has said, play it out wide, get Arteta involved, but sometimes it gets all lost in the game when you're playing out there?
It can do with the situation you're in and how much is at stake, and the atmosphere of the fans and everything else all comes into the equation. I think there's a little over-reliance on Arteta to be the creative element. I think Cahill's a big miss for them.
Another corner for Everton. Yobo and Stubbs forward again. And each of you right in front of David James. It goes in towards that area. And Howard Webb has blown his whistle once more.
I've seen a lot of quality from set pieces. But this time, the referee sees an infringement. And the chance has gone again. David James with a wry smile on his face.
Well, it's the manager David Moyes doesn't look best pleased. There's James Beattie, seemingly enjoying himself there on the back of the Everton dugout.
I thought he was on a space hopper there. He was up and down. What was going on there?
Well, I wonder where his future lies, linked with a move to Celtic this week. Not playing today, and each of me and Vaughan starting ahead of him.
But if they're going to throw balls forward like they have been doing, he's your man to be on there.
Osman looking for an each of me. Monroe finally well for Portsmouth.
Interesting team talk for David Moyes at half time. I'm sure he'll tell them to get it down and try and play the way through rather than just blast the way through.
Neville's throw in towards Sani Chibit. Arteta has got Neville out wide here. Neville with Carsley to aim for, goes beyond Carsley, and then it's Sani Chibit who scuffs it forwards. There's Fernandez. Everton looking to take the lead before the break here. Arteta, faced by Traore. Everton throw in.
Oh, a good moment for Everton there, playing the way in, getting Phil Neville in. Decent cross to the far post, it was a good chance. And Ichibi just snatched at it.
Another long throw by Phil Neville. And Ichibi claims he was impeded. Too much hype there at the back for Everton to try and get past in terms of the Portsmouth back line.
I'd like to see them mix it up from throw-ins. Everyone's gone long so far. Just change it a little bit. Get the opposition guessing. You throw it short, and you get them thinking, oh, I was expecting that one to come in the box, and then they've got to defend. They've got to come out and close down.
Lindboy Primus finding Glenn Johnson. Stumbling over, presents the ball back to Everton. This is Osman. Vaughan has made a dash just behind Lindboy Primus. Slices his clearance behind.
Well, nearly came off, didn't it, from Osman. Spotted the run of Vaughan, but again Primus. Immovable object at centre half.
Corner quickly taken. There's Mikel Arteta. Still Arteta. Lescott straight to James.
Trying to pass it in. What else he could do? He's composed with that.
Immediately Portsmouth trying to respond. Benciani. Franchard just behind him, that's a good ball to O'Neill, chance here for Portsmouth, and the chance goes begging for them.
Well, he should have his head in his hands as well. That was a cracking opportunity to go 1-0 up. Terrific awareness here from Benciani. Stays on side, you see him just check back, and all you want to do, hit the target. He tries to smash it, maybe too hard, instead of concentrating on making Tim Howard work, and he's well wide in the end.
2 minutes of injury time to be played at the end of the first half. And Portsmouth could have been in front. It was a well-worked opportunity.
One terrific chance each.
There's Fernandez. Lescott continues his run forward. Vaughan now. Arteta in field, goes back to Fernandez. Portsmouth again with 10 men behind the ball. Johnson misses the challenge. Here's Lescott. Carsley in the middle. Will be another corner.
There must be a magnet in the ball and somewhere on Primus, because everything's going towards him at the moment. I think Everton are just starting to play the way round, with Lescott being an influential figure. and Philip Neville being an influential figure. They're getting a bit of space, a bit of joy down the flanks.
Plenty of bodies in front of David James again, and David James, they get fingertips on that. Neville's after this. Benchoni shows good strength, and Portsmouth come forward on the counter-attack again. This is Lauren. And it's O'Neill who's made the break forward. Fernandez tracking back. And Manuel Fernandez putting the boot in, and it will be a throw-in to Everton.
They do spread it well, Portsmouth, when they get the chance. They do get it wide.
Well, he says they have to win here today, Harry Redknapp.
We saw a problem there for Everton when Lescott does get forward. He's a big gap, and Portsmouth have tried to exploit that whenever they can.
Well, that's it for the first 45. A goalless first half. James Forman, the best chance for Everton. Best chance of the game too, but he fired wide after Anichebe's flick and played him through. Tim Howard, not too much to do. Portsmouth right at the death though at the end of the first half with an opportunity, but Gary O'Neill fired wide of Tim Howard's goal. But not much for the keepers to do at all in the first half at Goodison. Half time, it's Everton 0, Portsmouth 0. Well, it's been a nervy first 45, such a big prize potentially at stake for these two teams. Both managers though will be calling for better quality in the second half. No changes at the break. This is Neville. O'Neill for Portsmouth looking for Carnu. Neville rising with Carnu. First time ball forward was by Carsley. Neville again asking James Vaughan to chase. Traore back. Well, Fernandez.
Everton have got to get the strikers working in tandem a little bit better. Too square with each other. Difficult to pick one out. See them now, they're about 6 yards apart and in line with each other. It's easy to defend against. When one drop short, you've got to go with him. That creates a hole behind for midfield to go into. But at the moment, very static.
Mikel Arteta caught that. Everton wanted to take the quick free kick. Webb showing the yellow card to Sean Davis for that challenge.
I think that pushes Mr. Webb into the lead in yellow cards for the season.
Promise again in the way of that free kick. There's Arteta. Fernandez, and each of it back to goal, but rolling his man. Neville with the cross towards Leon Osman.
That is a lot better. Got the ball into feet. Get Phil Neville forward again, who has created problems with his delivery.
The free kick to Everton. You'd imagine the message from David Moyes to his side would be get the ball out wide, try and get around Portsmouth rather than play through them. For Portsmouth, they look a threat when they broke forward on the counter-attack.
There's a lovely little flick from Arteta there, and he's expecting one of his strikers just to drop a little bit deeper to read that flick and latch onto it. But again, the two young strikers were too flat with each other.
James Vaughan and Victor Anichebe in the Everton attack. Both raw, both young, both big talents here at Goodison Park. Both signing new contracts this week.
A lot to work with there. You've seen enough so far. Pace. Got clear ability, but it's about learning how to play as a striker. Playing alongside somebody else.
Here's Anichebe. Arteta the furthest man forward here. Anichebe's played it round. Traore to Arteta. Three Everton players on the edge of the penalty area. Arteta gets across and towards Osman. Lee Carsley! Everyone thought that was it,
including me and you. When it came through to him, you thought, well, it's just going to burst the back of the net here. Again, they get it wide. Good early run by Arteta. Drags defenders wide. Not good defending. They let him turn, get the ball in the box. Good dummy here. You think, well, again, hit the target. David James going the other way. Just let him get the ball in. Passes Osman. Wraps his leg round it and just grazes the outside of the post. But when it comes to him, you think he sets himself really well. Just hit the target and you have to say it's another glorious chance.
This is Johnson. Need to be back on the field. Catching challenge by Johnson on Lee Carsley. Play goes on and Carsley has stayed down. Lescott swinging the ball towards Anichebe, just behind Traore here. Anichebe just easily pushes off Traore. Vaughan in the middle. James Vaughan has Osman to his left. Vaughan tried to make room for the shot. Osman was screaming for the ball behind him.
I think it was meant for Osman.
Neville now. Five in the middle. Goes towards Osman. A chance gone again.
Well, again. You have to say, nicely crafted chance by that man. His delivery has been first class.
There's Fernandez now. Everton are turning the screw. Carsley square of him. Fernandez, well, he scored a cracker last week, but nowhere near on that occasion.
Nothing wrong with that having a go, but Everton fans must be wondering what they've got to do to score. Terrific ball in by Phil Neville. Ernest Arteta gets the ball, strong, plays in Phil Neville. Look how he steadies himself, could have panicked, gets his first touch right, gets it away. And David James misses it totally, and so does Osman.
Why miss with the header? Portsmouth will be happy just to see this spell out of Everton pressure. Just to try and quiet in Goodison Park again. James Vaughan takes the ball away from Primus. James Vaughan for Everton. Is that a penalty? Yes it is. Johnson with the challenge. Everton penalty.
Well, Johnson said he got the ball. Very, very interested to see this again. He's convinced that he got the ball. Does this well, Primus slips there, gives Vaughan the opportunity to get in the box. Don't think he does get the ball. Good pace to get away. Here comes a vital touch away, and that's a penalty. Didn't get the ball, can't lunge in like that. You have to time it to perfection. Well done, Howard Webb.
Brent Johnson, yellow card for the challenge on James Vaughan. Mikel Arteta with the pressure. This is a massive moment in this season for Everton and for Portsmouth. Arteta against David James. Mikel Arteta! 1-0 to Everton! And that could be the goal that sends them towards Europe.
Well, I think David James will be disappointed with himself. Seemed to get a hand on it. Yes, the right way. It takes a big man in a situation like this to step up to the plate and take a penalty. The knowledge that Europe is at stake. Here we see, guesses the right way, and that ricochets off him, and he'll be furious, I think, with himself that he got there and didn't keep it out. You have to guess, he does guess, just doesn't keep it out.
He'll be disappointed. He's delighted. Goodison Park is jubilant.
I think it's noticeable that have changed in the second half. And again, I think it's down to David Moyes setting his team talk at half time. The strikers are playing in a different way to they did the first half. And Vaughan, his pace caused a problem that gets the penalty.
It's down to Portsmouth now to respond. It's just as big a game for them.
It's noticeable too that we've not seen Lescott get as far forward as he did the first half. That's where Portsmouth were causing Everton problems. Every time he went forward, they were using O'Neill to get in the hole that he'd left. Not this second half.
Primus is drawn out wide again. Everton keeping the pressure on. They have the lead by a goal to nil, given to them by that man, Mikel Arteta. Osman trying to find Carsley. Well, Harry Redknapp's big complaint about this season for Portsmouth is lack of goals. They need one now. Everton, though, pushing for a second. James Ward is onside here, and he should be sliding in. Couldn't connect.
Well, the movement of the strikers is totally different than the first half. It's more intelligent. It's hurting Portsmouth a lot more in the first half. Wonderful commitment from Arteta. Beautiful ball. David James, give him credit for that. Closes the angle down. And Anabukchebe couldn't get that vital touch. Just too much pace on it.
Corner to Everton. Stubbs, Yobo, Lescott, all forward. Goes towards Joseph Yobo! 2-0! And the continent may be calling for David Moyes' side.
Well, nobody was with him there. It's a free header, downward header. And nobody on the line could stop it either. Quality ball in again, you have to say. David James livid with his defenders. And he's got every right to be. He cannot allow centre-half to have free headers like that. He's having a go at Johnson. He's given a penalty away and now he's saying, who was picking him up? Ball played in there. Half-hearted challenge. It's a good header. Primus gets in no man's land and the challenge there was an absolute powder puff challenge from Traore. It's a good header, but Traore, dear me. I think me at 50 could have challenged him and put that one in the back of the net. And he's got to be livid with that. And Harry Redknapp, I think when he sees the defending for that corner and that goal, will be livid as well.
Well, Goodison Park was nervy at half-time and in the first half. It's absolutely rocking now.
I think you've got to feel sorry for Harry Redknapp. A lot of his players haven't turned up for me this afternoon. Lauren's been totally innocuous. The front two have hardly caused Everton a problem. Don't look interested. And he doesn't deserve players' attitudes like that. Neither does a man I sat alongside him, Joe Jordan. I know Joe, how passionate he was as a player. I played with him at Man United. And to see what they're seeing out there, I don't think it's acceptable.
The change will be made now. And Lauren makes way for Portsmouth. Lauren, who's really turned into a utility man at Fratton Park on the right-hand side of the defensive midfield. He's off. And Arnold Mvemba comes on. Chance for the young midfielder here. The Wallow are also about to come on. There's Mvemba. On loan from Rennes. And Nico Cranshaw is also off for Portsmouth. And the pace of Lamana, the Wallow are, comes on.
Not surprised at those two substitutions. Cranshaw was very good with his delivery from set pieces in the first half, but been ineffective in creating anything, and Laura's just been disappointing.
Ball with Carnu. Well, he was looking for a little bit of dip that never came.
It's a long way out, but we'll try and produce something to get back in this game.
And you can see why Harry Redknapp wants more goals on his side. He'll be looking for a couple of strikers in the summer. It's part of his six on his wish list. 1,800 Portsmouth fans have made the journey to Merseyside today. They're still singing. It's been a great season for them in terms of where they are. And they could still yet maybe end up in Europe, but a defeat here will be a crushing blow because it will mean that Everton will be guaranteed to finish above them. Conversation there with James Vaughan. Big Dan Ichibe getting involved also.
He couldn't get out of the way. The boys just blasted it at him. I think the ball actually hit Soward Webb.
And here it is.
Well, Vaughan doesn't touch the ball. and then he's dragged out and he just smashes it anyway. How's he going to get 10 yards away for that? That's wrong. That's not a yellow card.
I think he knew exactly what he was doing there to get James Vaughan booked, didn't he?
Oh, just a bit. He's certainly racking up the yellow cards, Mr. Webb. He's near 110 for the season. Not bad, is it?
Gary Birtles has his abacus out here.
Well, you look at referees, how many yellow cards they're given. He was in second place behind Mark Clattenburg, but he's certainly taken a biscuit this afternoon and gone to the head of the class.
Big week, of course, for the referees too, to see who finishes top. Mvemba. Portsmouth looking for this goal, which will put them back in this game.
Then why did Conan play that wide? He saw acres of space.
There's Anichibi. Arteta's continued the run here. Anichibi towards Arteta, pokes it! Just wide. Could have been the third killer goal for Everton.
Well, they nearly get a goal again. And Cornu, there was acres of space on the opposite side. He turned back inside when he didn't need to. And in an instant, they're at the other end. Little touch, just glides past the post. But what was Cornu thinking?
Are those fans heading towards Europe?
They'll be getting the passports checked, won't they?
Johnson has done well. Towards Benjani. This is O'Neill. Up by Phil Neville. O'Neill didn't fancy that first time. Johnson with the header. Let's got away. Nkazi scrapping for Everton. This is Glenn Johnson. Oh, it's a shot.
Well, the chance had gone earlier than that. Really good chance. Nobody dare touch him here, stays on his feet. Carsley tries to usher him out. Johnson then just drags it across. Tries to squeeze it in at the near post, but no real danger.
Just so there is no way back for Portsmouth. It's going again, Mikel Arteta. Three in the middle towards McFadden. It's another chance.
Any contact there is a goal, isn't it? But again, Arteta, the architect. He's been terrific second half. Again, he twists, he turns, full of tricks, and then puts a terrific ball in. Doesn't get any contact, disappointed that he didn't. We talk about all the good things going forward, and there's been a lot of them for Everton second half, but the back four for me set the tone.
There's McFadden here. And a real tussle, no foul. And McFadden has gone berserk at Howard Webb. He's a tricky customer, James McFadden. Johnson for Portsmouth. Douala. Running at Lescott. Created enough room for the cross there.
And I'll talk about the back four, it's all been built on that. The back four led by him. Stubbs, Yobo, Phil Neville and Lescott. Especially second half, just looked rock solid.
Portsmouth still hunting a goal here. Again, though, no way through. Davis now. Mvemba. Luwalawa. Well, he set himself up there, Luwalawa. Comfortable save for Tim Howard. Yobo and O'Neill getting involved inside the penalty area there for a few seconds. That's a great touch by Arteta. Finds Fernandez. Arteta again. Now it's James Vaughan taking on Traore. We'll do where it is for Everton. Portsmouth determined to win the ball back. Everton get the throw in.
Well, Arteta has been mesmeric, isn't he, second half? Hardly giving the ball away, and that young man there has just given everything. Worked his socks off for the cause.
There's Vaughan again. Arteta inside of him, tried to sneak the ball through to Mikel Arteta. Chance here for Portsmouth to break. Luwalawa. And Johnny's ahead of him. Tried to flick it towards Douala. Again, Stubbs in the way. And how it clears.
More of a threat, Portsmouth, since the substitutes have come on. More desire from them.
Here's Glenn Johnson now. Everton just backing off. Johnson! And in the end, there was a comfortable save for Tim Howard.
It almost looked like there was a deflection there to take the pace off it. Like he was dipping over Tim Howard at first.
This is Osman. McFadden beat his onside here. McFadden and Naismith to aim for. Goes towards James McFadden. Corner.
Well, McFadden applauds Beattie there. He does well. It's his first involvement in the game. Oh dear. Talk about nerves.
Well, the Evertonians know they're within striking distance of Europe again. Who'd be a fan here? So many nerves.
Who'd be a coach?
Arteta with the corner. That'll seal it! 3-0! And it's Gary Naismith on the field for a few seconds. And the European dream draws ever closer for Everton.
What a finish that is, his first touch. That's when it all comes together for a manager. Make your substitutions, but ask questions again of the defending. It's a decent enough ball again. It's a good flick at the near post by Beattie. Terrific finish. He gambles, but once Primus is caught napping at the far post, the flick made it. Beattie's flick and bravery dives at the feet of James, and look at the relief. Delight, relief, every emotion is there for the fans. Not emotion for him though, not a good one. You've seen his defenders defend pretty poorly in front of him at times from set pieces.
Well, David James lost out on Europe on the last day of the season for Manchester City a couple of years ago. And he may have that sinking feeling again now.
Well, three pieces of poor defending, one for the penalty from Johnson, free header for Yobo. Nobody defended for the corner.
That's it! Everton are within striking distance of Europe. A vital win by 3-0. David Moyes jubilant. Mikel Arteta set Everton on the way, scoring from the penalty spot. Joseph Yobo made it 2-0. And Gary Naismith right at the death after Yobo got the second. Wrapped up the points on virtually for a couple of seconds before Naismith headed the third for Everton. Europe may be calling for Portsmouth. The wait goes on. It's finished Everton 3, Portsmouth 0.
David, a great way to end the home campaign here.
It was terrific. The second half performance was excellent, and you know, I have to pay credit to the supporters today. I thought they acted like a proper football club today. I thought they were magnificent, and I think they made as much a difference as the players did today.
It was a pretty tight and cagey first half, wasn't it? But you had that chance through James Warne.
Yeah, we didn't play very well in the first half. I was disappointed with first half performance, but it can happen at this time of the season. You know, we knew how important the win was. I told the players it was a must-win game, and at half time we got about it better, and the second half we showed what we're all about, really.
And it seemed really like the nervousness around the stadium maybe lifted with that first goal. Was crucial, wasn't it?
It was crucial, and you know, we had opportunities before, but I thought that Portsmouth played well at times as well. But in the second half, we were certainly up to tempo, and you know, we got a penalty, which I felt was a penalty kick. But as I said, I thought the crowd actually made all the difference today. I thought they were nothing short of magnificent. They really were.
And it shows what a stadium can do in terms of turning a game sometimes, doesn't it?
Well, I've been very fortunate. I started my career at Celtic, and I know what crowds do, and I know what they can do up there on big European nights and when things matter. I thought the Everton supporters made a big difference today.
Two players you had up front, James Warne and Victor Anichebe. I know we've been talking about them for the last few weeks. Again, they worked their socks off and showed why you've given them new deals this week.
Well, both of them have got great potential. You know, they both are at slightly different bits in their career at this moment in time. You know, at different times, one's doing well, other one's not quite so well. But today we had a decision to make. We wanted to get them both in the team, and I think they've both done the supporters proud and done Everton proud.